That's a really pretty song. I wish I could play like that.
You will. You just gotta keep practicing.
Stop.
Hey, give that back.
You can't even play it.
That's not nice. Who needs a sister like you?
Who needs a brother like you?
Hey, guys. You know, when I was younger, I used to beg your grandparents for a brother or sister, like what you guys have, but that never happened.
But look how blessed you are, being an only child.
Yeah, having a sister like her is no good. A brother like me, though.
You guys need to stop putting each other down. What does the Bible say about this?
Respect your elders.
What's our one rule?
Everybody love everybody.
Get along, okay? He's getting better.
It's really not.
It's okay. Hi, Jeff.
Hey, Serena. What did they say?
Yeah, they said that I can stay here for tonight.
So the manager is going to kick you guys out?
Yeah, to move out by tomorrow.
Did you call the shelter?
Yeah, maybe tomorrow. Hey, Jeff. Do you want to go to that church?
I don't know. I will see.
This isn't fair. He made fun of me first.
Well, Jesus washed his disciples' feet, so that's what we're doing here.
Well, at least my feet aren't as bad as the disciples' feet.
That's true. Back then, they wore sandals and walked everywhere.
In John chapter 13, verse 5, it says, "After that, he poured water into a basin, and he began to wash his disciples' feet and to wipe them with the towel from which he was girded."
I want to be like Jesus.
Well, here's your chance. It's your turn.
The last one.
I challenge you guys all to take a look at yourselves, at your walk with Christ.
Why this church? Do you know anyone here, Serena?
No, but before my boyfriend Mark went to jail, he told me about the church.
Oh, really? Anyway, he needs to be locked up for life. Who beats women like that?
Shh. I don't want people to hear.
Do you have cold feet? You want to go?
I'm such a sinner.
I don't know much about the Bible, but my grandma used to say that Jesus came for sinners.
So you believe I'm a sinner?
No, I don't really mean that. I'm just trying to say.
Where you are, where you're heading. Look at your relationship. Is it a real relationship? Or are you just going through the motions? When you read the word and you pray, is it just because you're checking off a list? Or do you have a desire to know him more? We can all open our Bibles to Matthew chapter 7, verse 21. And it says, "Not everyone who says to me, 'Lord, Lord,' shall enter the kingdom of heaven, but he who does the will of my Father in heaven." We must live according to his word, to his will. If there's anyone here who feels they know that they haven't been living according to his word and his will, I invite you to come forward and give your life to Christ. Is there anyone out there who wants to give their life to Jesus?
Thank you. really glad to see you.
My life is such a mess.
God will give you a new life.
I don't want to live like this.
You don't have to. Is this your husband?
No, he's a friend.
Are you married?
No.
It's all bow our heads. Repeat after me. Say, Jesus.
Jesus.
I accept you.
I accept you.
As my Lord and my Savior.
Lord and my Savior.
I believe that you died and you rose again.
I believe that you died and rose again.
So, what's wrong?
You know, my problem with the church is...
What's that?
It seems like all they want is my money.
Well, how much money do you have?
You want to know how much money I have?
Sure.
This is how much money I have. You want it?
No, I'm good. Would you like to see how much money I have?
Yeah, show me. Wow, you're rich.
Well, this isn't my money. This is God's money for his kingdom. God owns the cattle on 1,000 hills. That's what the Bible says.
You think he'll bless me with some of what you have?
Maybe one day. You just need to understand, not all churches are after your money. It's used for the kingdom. The people give so that we can give back. Like what you see, what we're doing here. Not all churches are after your money. I'm sorry you got that impression.
I understand.
Did you get some food yet?
Is Pastor Joe here? I need to talk to him.
He's not here.
Figures. He's always helping someone.
Helping somebody's good things. You okay?
I'm fine. Perfectly fine. Okay.
Mom, don't worry. Pastor helped us get a place. It's the nicest apartment I've ever been in. Pastor really helped me out.
I'm so glad you found the church.
You should come and see me sometime.
I'm not ready to come to Jesus yet.
Mom, you used to go to church.
You know I stopped, girl.
You can't just drink your life away, Mom.
I stopped drinking already.
Mom, you need Jesus.
Maybe someday.
Mom, someday might be too late.
You know, since you're going to church, can you pray for your brother? He's back in jail.
Hi, London.
Is Pastor Joe here now?
In his office.
Thank you.
London, you okay?
I'm fine. Danny, you need to do your homework. Homework time.
Oh, come.
How you doing?
Do you regret adopting me and Danny?
No, of course not. Where did that come from?
I just feel like a disappointment sometimes.
We love you. Call me. Hello?
Hi, is this Pastor Joe, Danny's dad?
Yeah, this is him.
This is Nancy White, Danny's teacher.
How can I help you?
I'm calling because I'm actually a little concerned about Danny.
Really?
Danny hasn't been turning in any of his homework assignments.
Yeah, no, I'm sorry.
I'm gonna talk to him.
Danny.
Come on, just 5 more minutes. I'm almost done.
You're always almost done.
Come on,
you
just
need
5 more minutes.
Your homework.
I'm almost done, really.
Homework time.
I always say you have to treat me like I'm a kid.
Love you.
At least I still have you.
Okay. Thank you. Bye. Danny.
He didn't do his homework again?
Your brother needs some prayer.
He needs more than prayer.
At least I have a daughter who likes her homework, right?
I do it, but I don't like it.
Really? I thought you liked school.
I hate school.
Is everything okay?
Yeah, it's fine.
You want to talk about it?
It's getting late. We should go home.
Sure. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Now go pee-pee.
Concerned about Danny.
Yeah, me too. His teacher called.
Is he in trouble?
Yes, no. I
think he's been playing video games too much.
Yeah, we're gonna have to dial that back.
I think it's messing up his focus.
Yeah. Because of the games.
What did his teacher say?
He just hasn't been doing his homework. We'll need to have a meeting.
Yeah. Marriage is honorable among all, and the bed is undefiled, but fornicators and adulterers, God will judge. Fornicators. Lord, please forgive me. My sins. I knew it was bad, but it didn't seem bad. Thank you for bringing me back. In Jesus' name. Amen. My sons, you'll be different from my brothers. No drugs, no jail, no alcohol. God will help you.
Father God, be with us in this time, Lord God. This family needs you, Lord God. Watch over us. Give us wisdom. And let's put you first. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. Am I in trouble?
Yes.
Listen, we're going to open the Bible and read from Matthew chapter 25, verses 14. And it says, "For the kingdom of heaven is like a man traveling to a far country who called his own servants and delivered his goods to them. And to one he gave 5 talents, and to another 2, and to another 1, each according to his own ability, and immediately he went out on a journey. He had received the 5 talents, went and traded them, and made 5 more talents. And likewise, he had received 2, gained 2 more as well. But he who had received 1 went and dug it in the ground and hid his Lord's money."
I would be the one who multiplied their talent.
No, London, that would be me.
What talents do you have? Playing video games?
Well, I am actually pretty good at them, so...
Too bad the Bible doesn't teach us about playing video games. It teaches us about our responsibilities. And you buried yours.
I didn't bury anything.
Danny, we all have responsibilities. Me as a father and a pastor, I have responsibility over this household and this church. Your mom has responsibilities over you guys, and... You have responsibilities as well. You have to focus on your studies and grow.
But I've been doing my homework.
Well, when's the last time you turned in your homework?
See, it's been so long he doesn't even remember. You have been playing games a little bit too much.
Danny, let's read on and see what happened to him who buried his talent.
And after a long time, the lord of those servants came and he settled accounts with them. So he had received 5 talents, came and brought 5 other talents, saying, Lord, you delivered to me 5. Look, I gained 5 more beside them. And his lord said to him, well done, good and faithful servant. You are faithful over a few things. I'll make you rule over many things. And he who had received 2 talents, he came and said, Lord, look, you delivered to me 2 talents. I've gained 2 more besides them. And he said to him, well done, good and faithful servant. Enter into the joy of your lord. Then he who had received 1 talent came and said,
Lord, I know you to be a hard man, reaping what you have not sowed, gathering what you have not scattered seed. I was afraid, and I ran and hid your talent. There it is, what is yours.
Wicked and lazy servant.
Am I gonna be grounded?
Well, then he looks like we're gonna have to take away the games for a little bit. But we don't want to just do that. We want you to understand why. We all need to focus more and put in some more effort, okay? You with your homework and your studies, all of us need to put in the effort to have some more love and compassion. We need to check up on his homework and see what he's doing. But we want you to understand, do you? We're going to pray, okay? Let's all bow our heads.
Oh, don't forget to cast out his gaming demon.
Don't forget to cast out that nasty demon.
Father God, we thank you for this time. God, please give us understanding and love for one another, Lord God. In everything we do, let us put you first. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. You know we had to have this meeting because of you, Danny.
It's not my fault. I'm just a teenager.
We don't have teenagers in this house.
What is that supposed to mean?
It means you don't get to use that as an excuse anymore.
Really?
Yes, really. But you'll be okay.
Oh! Hey, Pastor! Can you pray for my tooth? It hurts!
Hey, Sarah.
Oh, I'm sorry, Sarah. Father God, we ask that you heal Sarah's tooth. Like that, we ask that you strengthen her teeth so she may enjoy the savory delights of apples. Your will be done in her life. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
I'll see you in church on Sunday, okay? I'll be praying for you, all right? Take it easy with the apple, okay?
I want you to come to church with me this Sunday.
You know, churches are filled with people who don't have a brain.
Are you trying to say that I don't have a brain?
No, I'm not saying that. Most of them.
Our children need something.
Yeah, they need clothes and a cell phone.
There's more to life than clothes and nice things.
When does their father get out of prison?
He'll be in there for a couple more years.
Still can't believe he tried to kill you.
I didn't feel safe in my own home. He beat me every day.
I hope he never gets out.
Can't they give me something I actually want?
Something like what?
Beer, wine, whiskey. I'm not picky, just something else.
I actually like food.
Do you want it? I don't want it.
Oh, for sure. Thank you. That's nice of you. Oh, yeah.
Hey, Pastor. I need some prayer, too, if you don't mind.
Yeah, what's going on?
It says somewhere in the Bible, God doesn't give us fear.
I'm glad you still remember your scriptures, Mom.
Me and God! Jesus still loves me.
Remember when I was 14 years old? And we went to a Pentecostal church. We were happy back then.
You're right. We were very happy. That's before I met Don.
Then you stopped going to church and started drinking with him.
Well, I had to make a choice. It was either him or Jesus.
So you chose him. Then he left you with a broken heart and alcohol.
I don't need this. I don't need that. I don't need that. I don't need this.
Your will be done in his life. By your stripes, this man is healed. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. And thank you. But to be honest with you, I don't think God really hears my prayers.
I know it seems like that sometimes, but I promise you, God does hear everyone's prayers.
I really find it hard to believe, to be honest.
I understand. Just gotta have faith.
And you're right. Well, you need to go home, get some rest as well.
I will.
Hey, Pastor. Feels better now.
Well, that's good to hear, Sarah.
Good for her. She is something else. I don't know what happened to her family, but she's really something else.
Praise God.
Amen.
I hope to see you in church on Sunday, okay?
Yes, sir. We do. Thank you.
Thank you. See you.
All right. I see you then Sunday. God bless you. Hey, Johnny.
Hey.
You look happy.
I just spoke to my dad.
Oh, great.
He said he loves me and he wants to come see me.
Wonderful.
Hey.
Pastor, love is the answer.
Love always wins.
Hey, Pastor, I wanted to thank you for healing my heart.
That wasn't me, Johnny. That was all God.
But you were the one who showed me what to do.
Johnny, I'm just a vessel. A vessel for Christ.
Well, I want to thank you anyway.
I'll see you at church on Sunday, right?
No. I'll be there.
I hate working outside.
You hate doing any kind of work.
That's not true.
Name one kind of work that you like to do.
I like cutting the grass.
Really?
Yeah.
That's good.
I should not have opened my big mouth. I'm so hungry.
You're always hungry. You might as well change your name to Hungry.
I'm hungry because I worked so hard today.
Daddy, it's a good thing that you work hard. You know, the Bible says those who don't work shouldn't even eat.
How do we feed the homeless then? That's different.
Feeding the homeless is a ministry, and it's a way to help and save those who are lost.
What scripture is that?
Luke 19, verse 10, it says, "For the Son of Man has come to seek and save those who are lost."
I'm glad Jesus found me. You were lost? In a way.
But then Pastor Joe found you like he found us.
I didn't find anybody. It was all God. And I'm grateful for that every day.
He who has an ear to hear, let him hear. Please listen. There are some of you here tonight who feel like God has given up on you, like there's no chance. Maybe you've done too much in your past. Maybe you've done too much this morning. God is here, and he's searching for you, for your salvation, for your soul. Let's all turn our Bibles to Luke chapter 15, verses 3 through 5.
This is the church my jail buddies told me about, all right? They can help us.
Michael, I don't think they're going to help us.
They helped Tasha.
Who is Tasha? Why are you always talking about Tasha? Are you...
No, all right, it's not like that. She's like 30 or 40 years old.
I don't care. Anyways, I just don't like churches.
Well, I don't either, right? But they got everything. Food, shelter.
I'm not going.
Carmella!
And it says... So he spoke this parable to them, saying, "What man of you, having 100 sheep, if he loses one of them, does not leave the 99 in the wilderness and go after the one which he has lost until he finds it? And when he has found it, he lays it on his shoulders, rejoicing." Jesus is looking for you, for your soul. I ask you this question. Is he moving on your heart tonight? Is he looking for you? I welcome you to come forward, give your life to Christ, become a new creation.
Pastor, do you mind if I help pray for these guys?
Yeah, please, please. Let's all bow our heads. Let's all repeat after me. Jesus.
Jesus.
Forgive me. For all my sins.
For all my sins.
Wash me.
Wash me.
With your blood.
With your blood.
Now what?
We gotta find a place to sleep. Corner store, abandoned building, a bridge again.
I don't want to sleep under the bridge again. Behind a building feels safer.
All right, we'll go behind the building. It's fine.
Tuesday. Okay. Thank you. We'll see you then. Thank you, Jim.
Thank you.
Hi.
Hey. Oh, he's just so cute.
Thank you. I really like children.
Well, you should consider working with our children's church.
Okay. I seen on a bulletin that you were looking for 5 faithful people.
In our bulletin. Yeah, and God's put it on our heart that we're looking for 5 faithful members that will help build the kingdom of God. Would you like to be one?
Yes.
I'll look forward to that.
I have a prayer request.
Sure.
I really like children, and I was hoping one day I could open up a daycare of my own.
We'll pray and see what happens. You know, we've been considering opening a daycare ourselves.
Really?
It's really nice meeting you, Serena.
You too.
Excuse me, is Pastor here? Excuse me.
Oh, oh,
is Pastor here?
Yes, he's here.
Is there something wrong?
No, nothing's wrong, babe.
The women in the church wear longer skirts, but this is all I have.
Then we need to go shopping.
Hey, Jesus loves you. Take care. He loves you. Hey, brother. Jesus loves you, man. Hey, take care. Hey, I got something for you.
I don't want what you have. I don't do drugs.
Excuse me, sir. What is that?
Jesus, man.
Okay.
Hey, Pastor, come help me pray with this guy.
Okay.
Hey.
Hey.
You looking for the Lord?
Yes, sir.
We can help you with that.
Okay, thank you.
I just need another drink.
Well, do you need me to call 911?
No, don't call 911. Don't call 911. I'm a nurse. I can take care of myself. Don't call 911.
Are you sure?
I'm sure. Just give me some water. Give me a drink of water.
Okay.
Last Sunday's teaching, about Jesus when he left the 99 sheep to go find the one, kind of reminded me of myself.
Really?
When Danny and I ran away, you looked everywhere to find us.
Let me tell you a story, okay?
Peter, we're missing someone.
Everyone is here, Jesus. Who is missing?
100 people came to the field with us today. Now there's only 99.
Oh, I counted twice. Let me count again. Oh, 1, 2, 96, 97, 98, 99. We are 100 here.
Count again if you must, but I'm gonna go find him.
Where are you going?
To find the one who is lost.
When you'll be back?
When he's found.
Someone help me! Jesus! What's you?
Everything's gonna be okay.
I'm sorry. I got lost. Don't worry. Thank you for not giving up on me.
It's okay.
If that was me, I wouldn't have looked.
Jesus will always look for his lost sheep. Every single one until they're found. Take comfort in that.
Mom, you need to drink this water. You need to stop drinking. You need help.
You know, you always did like babies.
I've always wanted to work with them.
Sometimes a dream is just a dream.
My pastor said that he'll help me open up a daycare.
Who is your pastor?
You should come to church and meet him.
Maybe someday. But aren't you about to go to the store? Could you get me something to drink? We used to drink in the nightclub together.
Yeah, I don't drink anymore. Jesus changed me. I'll see you soon, Mom. Love you. Bye.
Don't forget, get me something to drink and hurry back.
I've been trying to stop drinking, but it's hard.
Prayer and memorizing the Bible, that could help.
Can you please pray for me?
Father God, we lift up this young woman here, Lord God. We ask that your will be done in her life. Help her to overcome every unclean and evil desire. Help her to be an overcomer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. But just because I pray for you, it doesn't mean it's gonna happen.
What do you mean? What do I gotta do?
You have to hate sin. You have to hate alcohol. Only then can you overcome it.
Okay, true.
I'll be praying for you.
Thank you.
Food looks good. Enjoy your food.
Thank you.
God bless.
Thank you.
Did you finish your homework?
Actually, yeah, I finished it already.
Really? That's a miracle.
After listening to what Dad had to say, I changed.
How?
Well, the Bible says that we cannot have two masters.
So you're finally confessing that games were your master?
I guess so. When I play games, I couldn't think about anything else, like homework and Jesus.
You lost touch from reality?
Actually, yes. But I think it wasn't me. I think it was a demon.
Not everything is a demon, Danny.
Hi, Sister Serena. How are you?
Hi. I really need to talk to Pastor.
I'm sorry he's not here.
I really need to talk to Pastor.
Let me call you.
Okay.
Just wait.
Thank you.
Can I be homeschooled?
Why? Is everything okay at school?
They're just really mean.
Who's they? Do I need to go down there and cast out some demons? Ooh, I'm sorry.
Answer it. It's okay.
Hello? You okay?
You should have called me. You told me my mom passed away. I'm trying to get her to vomit.
I'm so sorry.
I just saw her.
her last words to me were, go and buy me a drink. It's gonna be okay. I'll pray with you. We're with you.
Hey. Were you waiting for me?
Yeah, kind of.
You okay?
Is that new lady Serena okay?
Pray for her, okay? She just lost her mom.
Oh. How old was she?
47.
That's old, right?
I know to you that's old, but she's actually really young.
Now I kind of feel bad for getting mad when you left.
I'm sorry.
It's your job as a pastor. You have to help people.
It's everyone's job. We should all help each other out. You sure you're okay?
Yeah.
You want to talk about school?
It's okay.
I'm here for you. Let's go inside, okay?
Should we go for a walk instead?
Sure, let's go.
Hi, Mom. I miss you. I remember when I was young, you used to read me a scripture. Isaiah 41:10. Fear not, for I'm with you. I will overcome this loneliness in this world. Thank you for taking me to church when I was young. I have some good news. Pastor Joe helped me open a daycare. Grand opening's tomorrow. I love you, Mom. Thank you for believing in me, Pastor, and making this happen.
Don't thank me. Thank God. He's the one who gave you the desire, and gave you that dream, and he's the one that made it happen.
I just wish my mom was here to see this.
I know she'd be proud of you. I'm proud of you.
We'll be right back.